What's up, you guys? This is Callie Carroll, and you are watching Postpartum with Fittcoach. So, like I told you, I'm just starting to video vlog. See, don't even know what I'm doing yet. And before, during my pregnancy, I did a lot of Snapchat. I did some of my actual like written blog, but thought I'd vlog about this process of coming back from having a baby and what that's like for your body. So just trying to give some different tips of like me, like, I guess it's kind of just like laughing at me trying to do momhood again. My babies are 14 and 12. So just figuring it all out. But I wanted today to do a 1 week check-in. So baby Q is 1 week old today. He's over, at grandma's house, which is like right out my door here. So don't get to show him to you, but man, he is freaking adorable. So far, momhood has been awesome. Some things that I've learned compared to when I was 24 having a baby to 39 is just a little bit different of like patience and calmness and like loving, I guess, there, where before I feel like I was a little bit more worked out. The number one thing is about my sleep, making sure with Kinsey, my oldest, that first 3 weeks, you guys, was like miserable for me. I literally didn't know if I was asleep or awake. Like yesterday, I'll give you an example. I took a nap from 3 until 4:45. And when I woke up, it was like that one-eyed, like, oh, I'm gonna barf, I'm so tired, like waking up. And that's what I felt like for 3 weeks straight with her, because I wasn't really remembering to take care of my body. So with this postpartum with Fittcoach, I'm a different type of person now, I guess. I really try to listen to my body and just discover what I need and how it can fit into my life. I know that it's hard with a newborn. You've got other kids running around. There's a lot happening. So how can you fit it in? I ask for a lot of help. I have a lot of help from my husband, a lot of help from my mom. If people say, hey, would you want me to, where before with Kinsey, I'm like, no. Like I want her like all mine, right? Where now I'm like, yes, I would appreciate that. So I say yes more often to giving. Those are some tips for finding a little bit more comfort, right, with these first couple weeks here. With that, for me, you guys, I've been trying to nap every single day. Before, like Quincy went to bed last night at 6:30, I went to bed at 7. So maybe it was like 7:20 or so, but I got the rest of my stuff done. And even though that's crazy early, I was like, I had stuff to do. I wanted to get on and do a couple posts of Q. I wanted to catch up with some work. My husband's gonna watch a movie, my son's up. And I'm like, guys, I gotta go to bed because I know that I'm the one waking up every 3 or 4 hours with him, right, to feed him and getting interrupted sleep. So I slept for a full 7 to 7 in between those feedings. And then I'm still taking my nap, where before I would be like doing, going, like, let me clean up this or pick up this. Like, who cares about any of that? Like, just take care of me is what I decided. And that's making a big difference. The other thing that I'm doing for my health right now, like really, you guys, is just listening to the stuff that I need in my body. During my pregnancy, I had this crazy sweet tooth. Normally, my nutrition is very good, and I love what I eat and what I do. That doesn't mean I don't have my like pizza and my Hefeweizen, like I say, like I love that piece of it. But every day, I have a couple smoothies. I do protein snacks. Then when I was pregnant, all of a sudden, I was like, no protein, no veggies. Like, I want sweets. I want sugar. I want candy. So I'm needing to get my body back to not craving those carbs because sugar is addictive, right? So I just make a decision. I made a decision when I have this baby that I am, you know, going back to my old habits. It's hard at first, but I'm going to go back to that. Now, at the same time, I'm hungry. Like, I don't ever have boobs, you guys. Maybe these look tiny to you, but like, I am making a massive amount of milk, right? Like, it's a hard job. If you're breastfeeding, your body's doing a lot. And even if not, my body's recuperating. Like, I just told my husband, like, it's a week later and stuff's still falling out of my body. Moms, this is gonna happen, right? We're like, oh my gosh, what is that? But you're still like, it takes weeks for that tummy to settle back in and to get rid of everything that's in there, right? So I've been like, that's just like part of the process. But with that, we're more hungry. We want more food than I usually eat when I'm not pregnant or breastfeeding, right? Even a little bit more than when I was pregnant, truthfully. So here's my habit. Here's what I've been doing. I just made my oatmeal. That's why we're here. I did a video for my clients about that. But I do an oatmeal with protein in it, and my protein has 21 essential vitamins and minerals. It's getting more protein, so I'm not just getting that in there, and it's making my breast milk fill in very good. So I do that for breakfast most mornings. I also, right as soon as I get up, I ask John to make my mama's brew, is what we decided to call it. And my mega water bottle, oh, it's way over there, you guys. You can see it's like huge. See where my finger's pointing right there? It's the 60-ounce water bottle. And he'll fill it up in the beginning of the day. And in that, like I told you on my first video, I'm putting in my probiotic, fiber, protein, collagen, a best defense, which is like vitamin C to keep me healthy. And that drink, like I look forward to it like no other. I just ran out of a couple of the things this morning. I'm like, like my mama's brew, like when is it gonna be in? So it should hopefully be shipped tomorrow. Please, I want it to be here. But that's been helping keep me hydrated and well nourished, right? And then aside from that, like I eat when I'm hungry again. And almost like you have to remember to eat, right? I ate sandwiches on full like hoagie breads where usually I would just eat the meat. I don't have the bread, but I try to choose a good carb and have that alongside with my meals. So eating more, listening to my body, doing all of my vitamins, definitely like I have some different things to make sure like my skin tightens. So I'm really working on that. All of my, like my prenatal still. And then outside of that, like, I think that's really it. You guys, sleep, hydration, vitamins, getting enough calories in. That's how I've been taking care of my body. My total that I had gained with Quincy was, I think it was 26 pounds. I still haven't done the math. I don't know why that's so hard for me. But here's my results. Like, here's where I'm at. I don't know if you guys can even like see. Here's week one, and I'm like, this isn't what my body did last time. Still, okay, so actual tummy. You guys have to see actual tummy, right? Just relaxed tummy. Still just like sticking out. Feel better on that. Like, but not that much, truthfully, you guys. I can pull it in, and this is like my only ab work for the next 6 weeks is gonna be me trying to pull my core in, because I don't wanna mess up any of my muscles in there. I already have some diastasis like in between here, like a separation, right? So just pulling in my ab muscles, teaching them to engage again. So that's where I'm at. I weighed 159 today. I weighed 176.8 when I delivered. So I'm down about 17 pounds or so. And I feel really good. I feel energetic. That's the main thing. I feel energetic. I feel healthy. I feel like I'm taking care of myself. I'm enjoying my time with my baby. Week one has been amazing. And we'll see what week two brings, all of the new adventures, but we're right kind of just tucked in the house right now. I do a couple adventures out for like 20 minutes. Here and there, and that's it, just keeping him healthy and me healthy. So that's week one for postpartum with Fit Coach. I hope that if you're watching this and you're going through or you're about to go through week one, you're doing amazing. Really listen to your body, take care of that sleep, take care of your hydration, stay up on your vitamins, and be patient and loving and calm as much as you can. So love you all. Hope that you're doing fantastic. Subscribe below, right? Like, so right down there, you have your subscribe, your like, your comment. I appreciate the comments so I can interact with you guys. It also helps me so that when I share these different things with my Project Mommy or my my moms who are getting results, bouncing their baby back, they can see what you guys are going through, and maybe I can address some of those questions or situations, whatever I can help with, right? So that's it. I gotta leave my oatmeal so I can make more milk. I hope you guys are doing fantastic. Thank you so much. Callie Carroll, Fit Coach, postpartum with Fit Coach, and we'll talk to you later. Bye.